glad to join you, if only by video, today, and I look forward to seeing you later. I've been reflecting upon the role of Dewi Sant in God's world and how you should show them.
Hi. Up the side.
Thank you. Welcome and good morning to Dewi Sant Welsh United Church. There are so many people here, and I'm just wondering, Daniel, did they find out that it's my dog Rudy's birthday today? Is that why they're here? No? No, why are they here? They're here to celebrate. They're here to celebrate Dewi Sant Welsh United Church and all that it has meant to us and will continue to mean to all of us who love Dewi Sant. Because this is not the end. This is the start of a new beginning. And so we celebrate, we give thanks, we acknowledge the tears, because, you know, it is good and right to love something so much that you cry. And then we remember in laughter, we remember in love, and we go out with a song in our hearts, like the Welsh always do. So get prepared for a lot of singing today. We've got Merche Dewi here. We've got some soloists. We've got lots of hymns. We've got ministers here. I don't know whether you noticed, but standing here with me is the Reverend Eilert Frericks, the Reverend Dr. Carowyn Davies, and the Reverend Mariel Simpson, who are joining with us today in the service. And the Reverend Dr. Larry Beach is also here with us as well, and he's in the pews. Where are you, Larry? Ah, there you are. Blessings. And welcome. And I am just feel so blessed and honored to have these ministry colleagues with me today sharing in this celebration. And also, I want to acknowledge Diane Matheson Jimenez, who is down here with her family. And she has been the Shining Waters regional representative to the Dewi Sant Transition Team. And she is here representing Shining Waters Region in this service today. So Diane, it's great to see you and thank you for coming. There is a communion service today. So those of you who are joining us via live streaming, you might want to get yourselves a little piece of bread and a little bit of juice when it comes time to celebrate communion. And I want to tell you that yesterday's festivities were so amazing and wonderful, and diolch and vair iawn to all of you who participated. It was just incredible. And there were 120 people live streaming on it yesterday when I went to that site. So we are being watched. We are being watched today, and I know this for a fact because people have told me that they're watching today. So it's wonderful to invite everybody into the celebration, both near here and far, via the wonders of technology. And I want to acknowledge the flowers that are on the communion table. One vase is from Timothy Eaton Memorial Church, where Dewi Sant is amalgamating, the amalgamation partner with Dewi Sant. And the other is from the United Church North Toronto Churches Cluster, which Dewi Sant has been a member of as well. And so we thank them so much for sending these flowers and remembering us today. They are all remembering us today. And the Reverend Lori Diaz and Elaine, the music director, was with us yesterday. And they will both also be back for the Gaman Vigani today in the afternoon. As you might imagine, they actually have other duties this morning, and so they couldn't be with us. And the Reverend Ann Hepburn was also with us yesterday, and she's coming again for the Gaman Vigani, but she also has duties and responsibilities this morning. So it's wonderful that we have all of these people joining with us today. And I believe some North Toronto Church members as well are with us. So that's wonderful to have you with us. And I want you to remember about the reception that's downstairs following the service and the Gaman Vigani this afternoon. One last Gaman Vigani to sing us on our way home. And I also want to acknowledge that there are people that we haven't seen for a while, like Clarice, and it's wonderful to have her with us. And we are so happy with all people who are joining us. But there is one person that we are missing, and Merche Dewi in particular, and that's Movie Owen Williams, and we are holding Movie in our hearts and sending her our love. So please remember Movie in your prayers and remember that and remember that Merca Dewi is missing them today. So thank you. And I hope I've said everything. Does anybody know of something I have left out? Speak now or forever hold your peace. Well, let us continue on then with our morning worship. And as always, we begin by lighting the Christ candle. And I'm going to invite Tegan Thomas, who has been the Christ candle lighter for as long as I've been here, and a lot longer, I believe, to come and do the Christ candle lighting one last time. We are a people of hope, gathered together in the name of Jesus Christ, who is the light of the world and our hope of new life. The light of Christ shines in us, and the hope of Christ sustains us. And I'll invite NAIST to come up and give our territorial acknowledgement.
Rydym ni, fel aelodau a chyfeillion Eglwys Dewi Sant, yn cydnabod fod y tir lle adeiladwyd yr eglwys hon wedi bod yn gartref traddodiadol I bobl yr Huron Wendat, yr Haudenosaunee, ac yn fwy diweddar y Mississauga o'r Afon Credit. Yr oeddent yn addoli yn eu iaith a'u ffordd eu hunain yn y am flynyddoedd lawer yn yr ardal hwn. Cofiwn a gwerthfawrogwn y cysylltiad yma wrth I ni addoli yn Saesneg ac yn yr iaith Gymraeg.
Diolch yn fawr iawn, NAIST. And let us join in our call to worship. This is the day that God has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. The time has come for the body of Christ, that is Dewi Sant Welsh United Church, to take leave of this building and property. This household of faith that was dedicated to God's glory on June the 11th, 1960, yes, yesterday, has provided refuge and comfort for the Welsh diaspora in Toronto and Canada. In this space, God's word and sacraments have been heard and celebrated by those gathered here today and by those who have gone before and remain in our hearts. The time has come for us to journey in faith in new and unfamiliar ways. We do so with sadness, but also in hope. We do what the faithful Welsh founders of this church did. We follow God's leading in trust and confidence. God is with us. God's Spirit guides us. Let us worship our faithful God. Our opening hymn is to the tune Joanna, How Firm a Foundation, and you are welcome to sing it in the language of your choice. It will come up in both languages on the screens. When there's a smaller crowd, we don't notice it quite as much, but it might be a lot more fun today with the two languages going. Please stand as you are able. And please be seated.
Let us pray. Loving God of creation, singing spirit of celebration, living Christ of liberation, we call to you this day, seeking your presence in our midst, opening our hearts to discern the way you will move us. Today, we ask that you lift us on the wings of your love, bless us in our endings and our beginnings, and inspire us to follow where you now lead us, in service to one another and to all the world. Loving God, risen Christ, life-giving Spirit, we lift our prayers to you. Compassionate God, surround us with your steadfast love as we celebrate and say goodbye to this sacred place of worship that has been Dewi Sant Welsh United Church's faith home for more than 6 decades. Assure us in this time together and in all times of endings and beginnings that you are with us, guiding us, comforting us, and cheering us on. Thank you, O God, for all the blessings you have bestowed and will continue to bestow on the Dewi Sant faith family, near and far. Amen.
Couldn't quite get my mic going there, sorry. Yolk to Mariel, and by the wonders of technology, we have the Reverend Alwyn Evans reading our first scripture reading today. It is a voice recording. We couldn't get his video, unfortunately, but it is a voice recording. So he will be reading this very well-known passage of Paul's letter to his first letter to the Corinthians in Welsh, and the English will come up on the screen.
Pesavarwn na thyfodau dynion ac yngylion, ac heb fod gennyf gariad, yr wyf elefydd yn seinio neu symbol yn tyncian. A phe byddai gennyf broffwydoliaeth a gwybod ohonof y dirgelion oll, a gwybod ohonof y dirgelion oll a phob gwybodaeth, a phe bai gennyf yr holl ffydd fel y gallwn symud o mynyddoedd ac heb gennyf gariad, nid wyf i ddim. A phe porthwn y tlydion am holl dda, a phe roddwn fy ngorff i'm llosgu, ac heb gariad gennyf, nid yw ddim sesad i mi. Y mae cariad yn hir ymaros, yn gymwyn asgar. Cariad nid yw'n cenffigennu, nid yw cariad yn ymffostio, nid yw yn ymchwyddo, nid yw yn gwneithur yn anweddaidd, nid yw yn ceisio reiddo ei hun, ni chythreddir, ni feddwl ddrwg, nid yw lawen am angyfiawnder, ond cyd lawen hau y mae ar gwirionedd, y mae yn dioddef pob dim, yn credu pob dim, yn gobeithio pob dim, yn ymaros a phob dim. Cariad byth ni chwimp ymaeth, aeth e pa un bynnag a'i proffwydoliaethau, hwy a basant, a'i tyfodau, hwy a beidiant, a'i gwybodaeth, hi a ddiflana. Bendith Dyw a fyddo ar y darllen.
And if you are wondering about some of these ministers that are part of the service, I'll just point you to the Rogues Gallery in the back there so that you can look at them when they were ministers here on your way down to the reception. Diolch and Val Iawn to Alwyn. And now I'll invite Donna Morris up to give the gospel reading. And Donna is the first baby baptized here in this space.
Long time ago.
it was just yesterday.
Good morning. Today's gospel reading comes from the book of John, chapter 13, verses 31, 34, and 35. The new commandment. When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you should also love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." This is the gospel, the good news. Thanks be to you, O Christ.
And thank you, Dioch, to Donna. Our next hymn is Penty Bedwin. It should be fairly familiar, I think, to everybody. And again, I will ask you to stand after Matthew has played our introduction. I haven't been up here since 2019, and gosh, this is high. Let us pray. Loving God, today we lift up our prayers for all of us gathered as the Dewi Sant faith family, for all of those who are present, those who are unable to be with us, and for all those who are in our hearts. We especially hold Mavi in our hearts and prayers today. We ask you to remind us that you sit with us in this time, that you hold us, and that your love enfolds us. And now may the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Well, of course I had to sing to you today. And yes, I'm getting out my Kleenex. So for those who either missed the last 2 weeks of worship or don't remember the last 2 weeks of worship, today's sermon is the third of a theme. The sermon on May 29th was titled Choose Hope. That was the day of our congregational meeting when the Dewi Sant congregation voted to agree to the amalgamation covenant with Timothy Eaton Memorial Church. And Timothy Eaton Memorial Church also did the same at their congregational meeting that day. Last week was Pentecost Sunday, the day we celebrate as the birth of Christ's church. And the sermon was titled, Choose Faith. And here we are, on this last day of worship in this beloved Dewi Sant sanctuary, gathered together as the Dewi Sant faith family. And my message to you today is choose love. Chapter 13 of Paul's first letter to the Corinthians is likely one that you have heard many times at weddings. However, when couples choose this reading for their wedding, I always provide them, whether they like it or not, with some context, because Paul was not writing chapter 13 to be read at weddings. Paul wrote it for a young Christian community that he had founded and who had made him rather upset, actually quite angry. Paul had heard disturbing reports about their activities after he had left them to go start another Christian faith community. So he wrote this Corinthian Christian community a letter that first expressed his disappointment with their behavior and then proceeded to instruct them about what living as and being a Christian is all about. Paul first presents an ethical grounding for being in Christian community and some distilled wisdom about why we gather together in Christ's name. He explains what Christian faith is about and the hope against hope that are the marks of true Christian community. And then after all his instruction in the first 12 chapters, Paul drops chapter 13. Paul says, regardless of what I've written to you for the last 12 chapters, the most important thing I have to say is choose love. I visualize this as Paul's mic drop. Paul says that all that really matters is that Christians gathered in community need to embody and live out Jesus' commandment to his disciples that we heard Donna read so well, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Paul tells those Corinthians and all Christian communities that follow, if you don't have love, you're nothing. You have nothing to offer to God's world and to Christ's ministry if you do not have love. In the most eloquent way, Paul gives the only rule for being in Christian community and being a follower of Jesus Christ. Choose love. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. This kind of love is not that sweet, mushy feeling that fades over time. This is the kind of love you really have to work at in order for its power to be felt in God's world. It stretches our human inclinations to the limit. We have to have patience. We have to rejoice in our neighbor's good fortune and not be envious. We have to work for the good of all, always, and put our pride and neediness and judgment on the back burner. And if we can do this, the power of this love is so strong, a force in the world, that it will never come to an end. The power of this love can overcome all obstacles and all traumas. This is big love, just like in the picture. This celebration weekend is all about choosing love. As I wrote in my greeting for the celebration weekend booklet, this weekend is a labor of love and a love song to all that Dewi Sant has been and will continue to be in the hearts of the Dewi Sant faith family. There is sadness because we will no longer be worshiping in this sacred space that for 62 years has been the container for the love lived out in Welsh Christian community. In our sadness, Paul has a profound message about this love lived out. It never ends. The love that birthed the Dewi Sant faith family in 1907 didn't disappear through all the changes and moving to new worship spaces that this congregation experienced. It won't disappear now. When you move to Timothy Eaton Memorial Church and become a part of this newly amalgamated body of Christ, as Kerwin noted in his ballad, the spirit of Dewi will still lead you on. Though closed be his chapel, his spirit will still ring to glorify God and to do the little things. And to remind you, that stained glass window will be at Timothy Eaton Memorial Church. And so today I have prepared a little reminder of the love that has been lived out by the Dewi Sant Welsh United Church. I contacted all of the living former ministers that you have had over these last many years, and I asked them to respond to this question. In your experience of ministering to and with Dewi Sant Welsh United Church, what is one way or event or thing that comes to mind that illustrates how the congregation lived out God's love in the world? As you might expect, most chose not to follow my instructions, I knew wouldn't follow my instructions. We've worked together before. Including the one about not taking more than a minute to a minute and a half, Kerwin. Some have sent video recordings and some have given me written memories to share with you. And so I am going to begin with the written memories and then we're going to watch the videos. This is from Louise Hughes on behalf of the Reverend Elwin and Louise Hughes. Reverend Elwin was called to Dewi Sant in 1965, and he arrived from Wales with his wife Janet, son Robert, who was 12, and daughter Rhiannon, who was 9. Gwyneth, his third child, was born in Canada not long after the Hughes family arrived. Both Alwyn and Janet were grateful to the congregation for how they celebrated Gwyneth's birth. Sadly, Alwyn's son Robert became very ill and eventually required a kidney transplant, which was unsuccessful, and he died just before his 18th birthday. The entire Dewi Sant congregation embraced Reverend Alwyn and his family in love and provided care and support to them. Reverend Alwyn and the Hughes family were so very grateful for that. Reverend Alwyn moved to a call at Rexdale United Church in September of 1974, and tragedy struck the family again when Janet died that October. The Dewi Sant congregation again rallied around Alwyn and his daughters and supported them with their love and care. On the happy occasion of Elwin's and Louise's marriage in 1976, the Dewi Sant congregation shared in the couple's joy and embraced Louise as Elwin's wife. Louise says that Alwyn and she are very grateful for Dewi Sant's wonderful, loving, and all-encompassing caring for them and for all of Alwyn's and Louise's family. This next one is from the Reverend Dan Evans. He and his wife Annette are out cruising on an extended cruise, he said, and their Wi-Fi is a little spotty, so he asked if I would just read this out to you. Dear friends, the impression I got immediately as I began my ministry at the church was of a group of people from different backgrounds with various hopes and ideals who could take the faith journey by various means, such as music, regular worship, celebrating festivals, Bible study, lunch bunch, Sunday school, food bank, social activities, before and after the services, to mention just a few. All these aspects have always been mixed together in a bowl of faith and a giant dollop of Christ's love mixed in, stirred. The result has been a perfect community of faith called Dewi Sant Welsh United Church. Annette and I send greetings, love, and blessings to you for this weekend and to your future. And this is from the Reverend Dr. Larry and Sandra Beach, who are here, as I said. At Dewi Sant, you have woven a tapestry in which you have blended the Welsh culture, traditions, and language, and the beliefs and values of our Christian faith, represented richly in your choral music with traditional Welsh words, and music together with hymns of faith. In our time among you, we deeply appreciated your hospitality and genuineness as you welcomed us along with others who are non-Welsh into your community of faith as the people of God at Dewi Sant. And this is from the Reverend Alwyn Evans. And he is watching today. Dear Liz and all my friends at Dewi Sant, I'm thinking about you all at this difficult time. I enjoyed 3 wonderful years with you, and I would comment on 3 things that I will treasure. First, I enjoyed preaching in the beautiful chapel. I was a little bit nervous preaching as I wondered who would arrive on Sunday mornings. It was a challenge that I enjoyed and a hope that I hope I communicated. The Toronto Welsh Male Voice Choir was founded while I was your minister. Having hailed from a family of choristers, that gave me great joy, an absolute thrill. I shared in many concerts with them, presiding and sharing a few jokes. And the social occasions where we shared a pint together were very lovely. The fellowship of the Welsh Society, both locally and across North America, opened up all sorts of pleasurable events. I was privileged to meet quite a number of Welsh people across North America. The Gymnasium in New York was a thrill. I am so glad that I had those experiences. Thank you for all that. Elizabeth joins with me in wishing you Godspeed. She has since those lovely days graduated from 3 universities and is now a proud mother of 3 children. May God bless you, and may you continue in the Christian faith. And from the Reverend Lord Roger Roberts, I remember so much at Dewi Sant during the time I was over. Perhaps the St. David celebration where we had a booth in the Eaton Center advertising the church and Wales. In those days, I was able to trudge the streets, calling at shops, and about 15 of them in Toronto flew Welsh dragon flags. Wow. Possibly the crowning function was the unfurling of the flags of Canada and Wales over the entrance to Dewi Sant, and the direction sign to the church being put up on Yonge Street. I was convinced that our Dewi Sant celebration dinner was the biggest in the world, until I heard that the Savoy in London, United Kingdom, had a handful more. I bet they counted the waiters. They were glorious months, always to be remembered. Huil Vaur, even though I'm so sad that you are leaving the church on Melrose Avenue that has come to mean a great deal to me, I will be doing my best to sing O Canada, as well as the title of the Welsh anthem that I still don't have down, Hen Vlad, say it right, you guys know it. Signed, Roger. And now to the video recordings.
Good morning, Dewi Sant.
Oh, sound.
It's wonderful to join you, if only by video, today, and I look forward to seeing you later. I've been reflecting upon the role of Dewi Sant in God's world and how you showed everybody what love is all about. And it seemed to me over the past few days as I've been reflecting that Dewi Sant, the Welsh congregation in Toronto, has very much lived into the doctrine of hospitality. The dinners, the music, all the celebrations that you have engaged in for so many wonderful years have endured, and they have shown your creativity, your love for one another, and your generosity of spirit. That is a very holy, holy gift, and I thank you. God bless. Bye-bye.
Is just by being there. But being community, not necessarily harmonious and peaceful, but being community that gathers faithfully week by week, Sunday by Sunday, as witness, as living testimony to God's love. Just by being there. By celebrating where we came from, and who we have become, by grieving together the people we and things we have lost, by remembering together, and above all, by praying together. We come together to hold up and bring into God's presence the joys and sorrows of this world. It's our ministry of praise and prayer and presence.
Bore da iawn i chi o bentre Saron yn Nyffryn Teifi. Mae'n ddrwg iawn gen i na fedrai fod gyda chi yn Melrose Avenue heddi. Mae rhaid i fi lywyddu yng Nghymanfa Gani Castell Newydd Emlyn a'r Cylch. Roedd haelioni amlwg ymlith aelodau Eglwys Dewi Sant pan oeddwn i yno gyda chi. Roch chi yn barod iawn i rannu a chyfrannu yn ôl y galw. Rwy'n ddiolchgar am y cyfle ges i weinidogaethu yn eich plith ar ddechrau'r ganrif hon. You have been at the centre of Welsh religious and cultural life in the Greater Toronto Area for over a century, and your life and witness together will continue as Dewi Sant's congregation is amalgamated with the Timothy Eaton congregation to form a new pastoral charge. I know about the care and planning that has gone into this new phase of your journey together as God's people. There has been laughter and tears, soul searching, reflection and remembering. And God, the Holy Trinity, the three in one and one in three, will honor you as you venture onwards anew along the path that God has laid before you. I pray in the words of Jeremiah Eames Rankin's hymn, God be with you till we meet again. Loving counsels guide, uphold you. May the shepherd's care enfold you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet at Jesus' feet. God be with you till we meet again. Abendith cyfoethog Dyw, a fo arnoch chi oll. Amen.
Bore da. If someone would ask me to define Dewi Sant, the church, in one word, I would say mother. In Welsh, mam. Because as the Welsh emigrants began to arrive in Toronto, what they longed for was a place to belong within a community of kindred spirits. And they found this in the Welsh Church, which became for them a mother figure. It became mam, in whose embrace they would cooch up and feel safe. And in her bosom were fulfilled in their spiritual needs. They could foster their ancestral heritage, and wherein they would offer Canada that which no one else could do better, the love of singing. Without the church, who knows how many of these folks would have been lost to God and would have turned their backs and their interests away from the land of their fathers. Four generations, 115 years, Dewi Sant has flourished, and his functions in this capacity have been unending. During 59 of these years, Nora and I have enjoyed an association with Dewi Sant, the church, which is second to none. This includes the 14 years which I had the privilege of being resident minister. And as we come today in a situation when Mam is facing a directional change in the way that she will serve the Welsh community, as she faces tomorrow, we offer her our gratitude, our thanks, in the hope that as she has served us, she will also serve the Welsh of tomorrow. God bless us all, and God bless Mam.
And so those were the Reverends Anne Hepburn and Eilert Frerichs and Alla Jones and, of course, Carowyn. And I'll point out that Nora is, in fact, singing with Merca Dowie today. So we are happy that Carowyn brought his better half. And as for me, this Vester Islandinger, this non-Welsh person that you invited into my midst. Well, in the first sermon that I preached in this sanctuary, I'm fine. On St. David's Sunday 2019, I made this promise to you. I will endeavor to speak and show the hope that is in me, and listen and watch as you endeavor to speak and show the hope that is in you. As we discern God's hope for us as the people of Dewi Sant Welsh United Church. I want to thank you, Diolch yn fawr iawn, for living out this promise with me, trusting me enough to confide your hopes to me, having the faith to discern and follow God's leading, even though it was in a direction you weren't sure you wanted to go. And having the courage to keep holding each other in love, even when it was hard to do, and especially in this pandemic time. Together, we have lived out the Spirit's hope, our faith in Christ and God's love in the world. And now, I release you from this ministry and from this sacred space to carry your hope, your faith, and especially your love, to your new sacred space at Timothy Eaton Memorial Church. Show those good people at Timothy Eaton Memorial Church that you chose love when you decided to amalgamate with them, and you will continue to choose love as you work together to be all that God dreams for you to be, as you live out God's love in the world. Paul told the Corinthians that God's love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. God's love for each one of us and for all God's world never ends, because the power of this love is so strong that it could not and it will not die. You will always be in my heart and my prayers as you journey on in God's love. And as we journey on new roads, we do not journey alone. God is with us. God's love surrounds us and leads us home. Thanks be to God. Amen. And Merica Dewi is, this is the world premiere of the specially commissioned hymn, anthem from Robert Arwin. And it is dedicated to Dewi Sant, and you can read that into Dewi Sant Welsh United Church, probably the saint as well. And you can read about that in your bulletins. Thank you. Amen, amen. And Diolchyn fawr iawn to Cheryl and to Matthew. And what a beautiful anthem that will also go with you to Timothy Eaton Memorial Church. We are, in fact, a richly blessed congregation and a group of Dewi Sant faith family. And so today we also remember that we are called to be a blessing in God's world. And we present our morning offerings. Now, there are supposed to be baskets in the back, I believe. So if there aren't, somebody check that out, please. And you can drop, there are envelopes in the pews. You can drop an envelope at the back. If you want a tax receipt, please make sure that you put your contact information on so that we can mail you a tax receipt. And we also have a collection for sleeping children around the world, which you can put up in these plates on the piano. We collect spare change for that wonderful, wonderful organization as well. And so at this time, I'm going to have the prayer over the gifts, even though we don't have the offering up here. We're going to pray in advance anyway, and I'm going to invite you to pray in the language of your choice. Gracious God, you anoint us with an extravagant love. In thanksgiving, we present these gifts of our hands and hearts. May they be used to love your world into wholeness. Amen. And at this time, I'm going to invite Diane Matheson Jimenez, the Shining Waters Regional Council representative, here with us today. And I'm also going to invite the members of the Dewi Sant transition team up to join me up here in the front. And you have to move. You want me to introduce the transition team members?
Sure.
Okay. So these are people who have worked extremely and extraordinarily hard for you over these past 3+ years. And Havina Phillips, Donna Morris, and Cheryl Clay Newell, and Peter Lloyd Jones, and Betty Cullingworth. And they are the ones who have worked on this process, who have led you, who have spoken to you, who have done so much that I could not do, in fact. And I just want to say Diolchyn fawr iawn and thank you so much to them at this time. And I wouldn't mind a little show of your appreciation for them. Take it away, Diane.
Thank you. We are always starting over. We are always beginning again. Something within us or about us changes. It is time to be moving on. Change is seldom easy. A friendship, a favorite spot, a familiar lifestyle slips away, and nothing is the same. May God grace all of our turning points with patience and peace. M.T. Winter. Friends, for just over 3 years, Dewi Sant Welsh United Church has been journeying in intentional interim ministry with the Reverend Liz McKenzie and the Dewi Sant transition team. Havina, Donna, Cheryl, Peter, Betty. With the Dewi Sant Community of Faith's decision to amalgamate with Timothy Eaton Memorial Church and to take leave of this building, The work of the intentional interim ministry is now completed. It is now time to give thanks to God for the faithfulness of the ones who have led the Dewi Sant faith family through this time of intentional interim ministry. Let us say together, we give thanks to God that you answered the Spirit's call to offer your skills and gifts to do this work and for your faithful leading in this time. Betty, Donna, Havina, Peter, and Cheryl. Upon the official board's approval, you are released from serving as Dewi Sant's transition team. You're not done yet, Havina. You have a couple more weeks. I'm sorry. We give thanks for all of the ways in which you have served the Dewi Sant faith family and for the ways in which you will continue to help make the amalgamation with Timothy Eaton Memorial Church a time of new life and possibility for Welsh ministry and culture in a new faith home. Members and friends of the Dewi Sant community of faith, the ending of the intentional interim ministry also marks the end of your covenanted ministry with the Reverend Liz McKenzie. Will you, the members and friends of the Dewi Sant community of faith, release Liz from the duties and responsibilities of intentional interim ministry and journeying with the Dewi Sant faith family? Will you respect the new relationship that now begins and offer your encouragement and prayers for her continued ministry elsewhere?
We will, with God's help.
Liz, will you release the Dewi Sant community of faith from their covenant with you as intentional interim minister, respecting the new relationship that now begins and offering your encouragement and prayers for their amalgamation and ministry with Timothy Eaton Memorial Church?
I will, with God's help. I thank all of you who are the Dewi Sant faith family for the love and support you have shown me while I have ministered among and with you. And normally, always in fact, I give a gift to the congregation that I've been ministering with. Think of it as a bit of a parting gift. And today is no different. And so I am going to bring this over. And this is actually with Eilert's help. I had to get him to deliver it to me when I found it. And when COVID started, I found these Hope Candles holders that a very close friend of mine had given to me for my ministry. And so I started putting them on the communion table as I was videoing my sermons, and then as we were doing Zoom. They have been here ever since the beginning of COVID, so that's 2+ years now. And it has been a symbol of our ministry together. We have been in a ministry of hope together. But today, I'm also sending you out on a ministry of love. And so I have a symbol that I hope that you will take with you to Timothy Eaton Memorial Church. Hold that that way. And you get the most important part, Peter. You've got the tea lights. And you can see that there are the hope candles there. But more fun is if you turn them around. So, and you're going to have to switch places now. There we go. Okay. Go to where Betty was. It's like herding cats, these folk. There we go. Peter gets to stay where he is. Lucky Peter. And guess what it says now? So I hope that you will be able to use these in your ministry at Timothy Eaton and be able to tell the stories to Timothy Eaton about the hope that we had together and still continue to have in our hearts and the love in which we are living out our ministries and living God's love in the world. So. And in honor of this occasion, I got Kleenexes. They all say God bless you on them. Indeed. One for you, because I knew you'd cry too. And one for me, because, you know, anyway.
Before I start weeping and need these lovely tissues, I would ask Anna Danette Swills, please, to come forward.
So, someone told me recently that I was the chair of the search committee when Dewi Sant was first looking for a minister who would become our intentional interim minister. It is so long ago, or it feels so long ago, that I had completely forgotten. We are so fortunate that Liz accepted our call. Amongst many skills, she's trained in the minutiae of the United Church governance procedure, rules, and regulations, which kept us on the path to successfully achieving not just our transition to Timothy Eaton United Church, the unexpected challenge of meeting under COVID-19 protocols, but also our regular Dewi Sant Church worship services and activities. And this last point is really important. Reverend Liz created meaningful and deeply spiritual services every Sunday, incorporating our Welsh music, readings, and culture. She gave us hope that even though we could not imagine life without Dewi Sant Church, we and our history would nevertheless continue on a new way. She reminded us that we are not alone. And I have to add that Reverend Liz really took to the Welsh language, so much so that she's practically fluent
practically
in a few key phrases. It's not surprising because of her Icelandic background and thus knowledge of that language. Icelandic has been consistently ranked as one of the hardest languages for English speakers to learn. So it's no wonder that Welsh was a breeze for Reverend Liz. On behalf of the session, the board, the stewards, the trustees, the emergency response team, the transition team, and the congregation, please accept these gifts as a token of our appreciation.
Night in the raffle. Oh, this is wonderful. Diolch and vál iawn to everybody. Thank you so very, very much. Like I said, I treasure my time here. I feel so blessed to have been ministering with you over these years. And you will always be in my heart, and especially if you call me to have wine in your backyard. Did I say that out loud? Thank you. Diolch and vál.
Oh.
You all.
Let us gather our hearts in prayer. In your great love, O God, you have blessed the many ministries of the Dewi Sant Welsh United Church. We thank you for this time of intentional interim ministry, and we ask for your blessings of comfort and support as it ends. Help Liz, the transition team members, and the Dewi Sant community of faith to cherish their memories of ministry together and to move forward to new ministries and new life with your grace. As disciples of the risen Christ, May we all continue to be channels of your steadfast love through Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Matthew. It's come time now to celebrate Holy Communion, and you all should have received a little juice and wafer container. If you don't have one, there are some in the narthex on the table back there. Does everybody have some? Oh, there we go. We have Rosemary in the back with some extras if you need to get some extras. So because of COVID, we're not doing it how we usually do it, which is by intinction. We have these lovely little all-in-one communion services. And so the first part, you tear the clear tab, and that's the host, and then the second part is the juice. So wait until I tell you, Betty. And we'll do this together. The ministers up with me will be having communion by intinction. As we come to this table, I'll remind you that this is not my table. This is not your table. This is not the table of the United Church of Canada and not the table of Dewi Sant Welsh United Church. This is the table of Jesus Christ. And all are welcome at this table. No matter who you are, what you've done, where you've traveled, who you've loved, you are welcome here. Christ invites you to share in this feast of love today. God is with us. We are not alone. Christ is present here. The Spirit is among us. Let us give thanks to God. It is right to offer thanks and praise. Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of light, giver of life, source of all love. With your breath, you formed all that we are and all that is beyond us. The heavens tell your glory. Your gifts of hope and new life transform us. We praise you for Jesus Christ, risen to life eternal as your love. Hallelujah. Love is stronger than death. We remember that vision of God's love shown to us in Jesus at table. He shared food with followers and friends, with saints and sinners, with crowds of thousands on the hillside, and a few friends in an upper room.
On the night before he died, Jesus had one last supper with his friends. It was a time of goodbye. It was a time of sorrow. It was a time of deep longing and profound hope. Jesus took a loaf of bread and, giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to them, saying, "Take,
eat. Do this in remembrance of me."
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he passed it among them, saying, "Drink this. Do this in remembrance of me." Through this loaf and cup, Jesus lives within us.
In word and deed, Jesus lives among us.
Holy God, pour your Spirit upon us, that we may know Christ in the breaking of bread, and that in word and deed we may channel and be channels of your love, peace and justice, and hope in the world.
Amen. Amen.
As Jesus prayed to you, O God, so now we pray as he taught. Ein tad ar hwn oed yn y nefoedd, sanctaeddir de enw, deled de darnas, gwneler de wachlis megis a nef, fechdi ar y ddaiar hefyd. Daro I ni heddiw ein bara bainyddiol, a madda I ni ein dyledion, fel y maddaw ninnau i'n dyledwyr. Ac nac arwain ni brofedigaeth, aeth yr gwared ni rag drwg, canys yr aeddo ti yw dernas, a'r nerth a'r gygoniont yn oes oesoedd. Amen.
The bread that we break is our sharing in the life of Christ. The cup for which we give thanks is our sharing in the life of Christ. So I'd invite you to take the wafer portion and we will eat together. the bread for the journey. And now I'd invite you to undo your juice section. And I'm going to give those who ate their bread up here a little more because I forgot about the intinction part. The cup of blessing.
Let us pray. Holy One of God, you have invited us to your banquet so many times, and we are thankful for your invitation. We have tried over the years to follow your footsteps and to follow the directions you give to us. You refresh us in this meal. You give us new life, new hope, new courage to carry your love into this world. Holy One, we praise your name. We give you thanks. Hallelujah. Amen.
And I am now going to invite Merkid Dewi up to sing another of Robat Erwin's compositions, and one that's become a favorite of mine since I began here, Bendy Gedig.
If this building, if this chapel could only speak, I wonder, what would it have to say to us today? So let us allow our imaginations the latitude and the freedom to listen in to the prayer of the chapel. The prayer, of course, has to open in Welsh. Ein tad, yr hwn oet yn y nefoedd. And to you, the God who giveth and the God who taketh away, the God who consecrated me those 60 years ago to become a home and a sanctuary to the Welsh as they came worshipping in a city far away from their homeland in Wales. The God who stood by the door as the first worshipper entered into my presence. The God who blessed the preaching from this pulpit. Who blessed the congregation as they raised my roof and raised my spirits in their Caman Vawoes Canny. The God who blessed the humble worshipper as they received of your love and your spirit. And the God who blessed the pots and pans in my kitchen. And fulfilled the joyful requirements as all Welsh people have. In our Nosweithi Llawen. Mine, O God, to you this day is a prayer of thanks that you gave me an opportunity of serving you as we came together to represent the only one United Church and Welsh Church in Canada. The God who will be standing at that same door today, as you did 60 years ago, and in the intervening years in between, you will be there today to weep and to feel joyful with the last congregant to leave this place today. And you will be with the congregation as they walk down Young Street and across the streets until they reach the great magnificence of Timothy Eaton Memorial, and there to find an open heart and a new bosom in which to couch up and find there a home and a blessing, and to be there a blessing. We pray, O Lord, that those who became a part and filled the seats in this congregation be with them and be with this new forming congregation, blessing your holy name and continuing to be a Welsh presence here in Toronto. Now, my day is over. My night is drawing nigh. Shadows of the evening steal across my sky. Will there be another day? Will I serve in another way? But for now, mae diwarnod gweithio wedi dod i ben. Dwg fi i'r ffwyso at y tŷ. Amen.
Well, it's been a bit of a marathon, and I want to thank my wonderful ministry colleagues here and also the ones who contributed to this service. And I want to thank all of you, the Elkin Valleyan, for being here with us. We will sing our closing hymn and remain standing for the commissioning and the blessing. And after we have spoken the blessing that we always end our services with, and we will speak the blessing in both Welsh and English, then the Merched Dewi with Gaynor Jones Lowe as the soprano will sing the second part of Robat Arwin's commissioned hymn anthem, which is the sung blessing and amens. And then Matthew will play us out to the reception. So we join now in Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
Thank you.
step here. Go forth from this sacred space. Continue walking with Christ in love and hope. Give thanks for all that has been shared in this sacred space. May our memories be springs of water when we are thirsty, rays of light when we are in darkness, and reason for rejoicing always. And now let us bless each other on the way. Glasine Hadway, the Azi Trees, a Cariadu, a Camdavis Verfazan, Filo Ginomo, or Arhan Hudbith. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and always. Amen.